This video is all about Instagram content. Specifically, in this video, I will share with you what you should and can post on Instagram as a small business. We will specifically look at different features that Instagram has to offer, and I will also share with you my thoughts and ideas of what you can create as a small business owner and what content will drive engagement, get more visitors to your website, increase your brand exposure, and more conversions. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. And if you're new to my channel, my name is Veronika. I'm a founder of a modest activewear brand, Futuration Apparel, a content creator and photographer. I document my business journey and share it all with its ups and downs, valuable lessons and practical advice to inspire women like me to pursue their passion, take action and craft the life that they deserve. Instagram is the perfect marketing tool for entrepreneurs, small businesses, and freelancers purely because of its ability to generate engagement. It's a place where people find inspiration and share their creativity with the world. Instagram is also very easy to use. You don't have to be tech savvy to make Instagram work for you. It's a great way to reach your customer in an authentic and personal way. Over the past few years, Instagram has become the most popular social media platform in the world. We all know that the best content to post on Instagram is high quality content, creative content, and original content. The question is, what exactly should you post? As a small business owner, I want you to focus on these four content types. First of all, behind the scenes content. It's very important to share with your customer what you do behind the scenes as a business owner. In this day and age, transparency within the business is very valued by our potential customers. They get to see you not as a business, but as a person behind the business. Secondly, I want you to focus on inspirational content. You can share stuff that inspires you personally within your business and create infographics or quotes that your audience will also find motivational and inspirational. That's where you can also reiterate your mission and your brand values. Thirdly, you have to show your product in action. Whatever content you decide to create, you have to have your product in mind and what your customers need to know about your product. What it is, what it does, and how it can make their life easier. A lot of the times, customers don't even know they have a problem. So you need to tell them what that problem might be and how your product and service can fix that problem. And the fourth type of content I want you to think about is the content from your customers. Let your customers tell their stories and their experience with your product in testimonials, and show your customers using and wearing and loving your product with your audience. That provides social proof. If there are people out there who are enjoying your product, that tells your customers that your product is good and they should probably give it a go. To create effective and engaging content for Instagram, you need to know what features you can work with so that you can make the most of it. So let's look at different features that Instagram has to offer. First of all, let's look at the Instagram grid. These posts are very important because they determine the aesthetic of your grid. That is one of the first things your potential client or potential follower will see when they land on your account. You can post photos and videos on your grid. It is totally up to you how you want to manage that grid, but I have a number of tips for you to keep in mind. Tip number one, keep it real but aesthetically pleasing. Show off your business in all its glory. Show your products, show your customers using your products, share the testimonials, and of course, share the behind the scenes. But make sure your grid has an aesthetic to it. It has a flow. It looks cohesive. Just because as Instagram users, we are very visual and we are so used to seeing great quality images on Instagram. So for your business to catch an eye of a potential client, you have to really put effort and strategy when it comes to planning out your grid. Tip number two, stick to your brand colors. Does your brand have colors? If not, then you should really decide on your brand colors that will help you keep the entire experience cohesive and on brand. You can go to this cool website called coolers.co and play around with different palettes. This website helps you easily generate different combinations of colors, look at trending color palettes, and find the one that you like. Then you can save the hex codes of those colors and make sure you use them consistently throughout your social media. Tip number three, keep your Instagram grid product or service oriented. You want to have your product or service front and center on your grid. Once again, it's very important for your potential clients or potential followers when they land on your account and they're not following you yet to know exactly what they're going to get if they decide to follow you. They need to know who you are, what you sell, who you serve, and how you can help them. So make sure your grid is not confusing. Tip number four, create shareable content. Things like inspirational quotes, infographics, are highly shareable. If your post resonates with the viewer and it has written words, great graphics, it's something that educates them or entertains them, they'll be more inclined to share your post with their audience, in turn exposing you and your business to their audience. And their audience might land on your profile, check out what you're all about, and start following you, potentially turning into a paying client or customer. Tip number five, utilize the caption space. Not everyone is going to read your captions, but the people who truly need your product or really thinking about investing in your product, they will read your caption. That's why it's your job to educate your potential clients about what you do and how you can change their life through your service or product. Talk about things like the benefits of your product, the process, your story, your why, and of course, your mission. And don't forget to share your customers' testimonials. That will definitely help to convert those who are on the fence. Tip number six, batch your content. Batching your content will take a huge amount of pressure off you and will help you show up consistently and effectively. You will get to plan out how your grid looks ahead of time. You can use scheduling apps like Planoly, or simply use Facebook's Creator Studio. Either one of those ways will help you visualize your grid. That way you can stay on brand and plan ahead. And if you are prepared, the likelihood of you showing up skyrockets. And that's what you want as a business owner, to be consistent and to create great quality content that is purposeful and meaningful. And tip number seven, this is the last one here. Make sure you post consistently. And when I say consistently, I mean at least once a day. You want to be in front of your customers' eyes. You want to be predictable, and it will also help you as a content creator to gain the momentum you need to keep up with the consistency. Did you get all that? Now let's move on to Instagram stories. I personally love Instagram stories just because it's such a great way to get your customers see behind the scenes, get to know you a little bit more, and get a gist of your personality. You can include fun boomerangs and time lapses of you working on the business, doing whatever it is you're doing in the business. Content like that will provide a great insight for your customers and it also won't mess up your grid. I'd say aim to post between 5 to 10 Instagram stories every single day. They don't have to be long, they don't have to be boring, they can be very diverse. But ideally, when your potential client lands on your Instagram account, you want to have that pink circle around your profile image to indicate to them that there is something you have to say and that you're definitely active. If on any particular day you don't want to show your face or there's nothing much happening behind the scenes, it's just you working at your laptop, for example, you can simply share the products and the photos of your products. Just make sure there is always something in your stories. Here's another thing that makes me really love Instagram stories. It's the engagement features. You know, the polls, the sliders, the quizzes, all of them are great to get your customer data and do some market research. That way you get to learn about what your ideal customer wants from you, and that'll help you plan for the future launches, and where you want to take your business. And just like that, we're moving on to the next feature, which is going live. A lot of people stay away from going live on Instagram because it can be scary. You have to talk on the spot, you have to come up with things, you have to be very articulate. There's a lot of pressure that comes with going live on Instagram. But it's such a great way to connect with your customers in real time. And your customers will really appreciate that. You get to educate them. You get to answer their questions. You get to invite people in your field who have some great wisdom and knowledge to share with your community and interview them. That way you can provide a lot of free value for your community. And your lives can also be very entertaining and engaging. You can even put together little slides to go along with your presentation. It just makes the entire experience very fun. Also, those slides really help you stay on track and kind of look at your notes without seeming like you're looking at your notes. And now you are able to save those lives as IGTVs. They're not going to disappear after 24 hours like they used to back in the day. That little interview or presentation becomes an evergreen content that your customers can always go back to. And that's how we move on to our IGTV feature of Instagram. IGTV is a space where you can share your long form video content, which is basically any video content that is longer than 1 minute. How long should your IGTV videos be? I'd say 2 to 4 minutes. I've experimented with my IGTV videos a lot, and the videos that are longer than 10 minutes tend to not perform really well just because IGTV is not searchable, and a lot of people are not used to going to Instagram to consume long form video content like they used to on YouTube. That's why I'd recommend posting videos that are 2 to 4 minutes long just to get the most audience retention. You can share things like behind the scenes vlogs and some educational content around your product or service. But remember to keep it entertaining. No one is going to watch a talking head for more than 30 seconds. So if you are going to educate people, make sure you spice it up with some B-roll and other shorts that go along with your story. It's honestly a great way to repurpose some YouTube content. If you're already creating content for YouTube, you can change the format to vertical, split it into multiple parts, and post them on your IGTV. Great, let's move on to the final feature, and it's probably one of my favorite features on Instagram. It's Reels. Reels allow you to entertain and educate your audience at the same time. I love Reels. But Reels can be intimidating, especially if you are just not a dancey, funny kind of person, or you think you're not. Before diving into it and feeling almost paralyzed with fear, go ahead and research what other accounts and other businesses in your field are doing with their reels. That way you get to fish for some ideas and find some inspiration. The reason I want you to focus on reels and really giving them a go is because Instagram pushes out reels to new audiences. That way you can find new customers. And reels have a chance to go viral, bringing hundreds and thousands of new eyes on your store. And recently, Instagram has come out and said that they will be prioritizing video content above photo content. So that should tell you that you, as a content creator, as a business owner, really should start focusing on expanding into video content. You can take part in trends and use trending sounds to share your message. You can always put your spin on it and reach more audiences that way. Creating reels will help your business grow. So that's why I don't want you to think about being comfortable. I want you to focus on growing your business and doing whatever you can to grow your business. So get out of your comfort zone and go create some reels. But don't worry, you don't have to put too much pressure on yourself to create every single possible type of content out there on Instagram. You can ease into it, you can trial it out, and you can see what works for you. But most importantly, you need to see what works for your audience. And please don't forget that hashtags still matter. The use of hashtags on IG is an integral part of user experience. They are a great way to expand the reach of your posts so that users who might be potentially interested in your product or service can find you. And if you didn't use the hashtags, I probably would have never stumbled upon your account otherwise. Hashtags are a good way to label and categorize your posts so that they can be easily found on Instagram. Creating content for Instagram can go a long way in helping your business grow and creating awareness towards your brand. The trick is to know how you can leverage Instagram as a marketing tool in your business. So now I want you to take it all in, get out of your comfort zone, and grow your business by using content creation on Instagram. That brings me to the end of this video. If you found value in this video, make sure you leave me a thumbs up, comment below, share this video so I can reach more women with this content and we can connect on this platform, and hopefully that'll inspire them to take action and start working for their dreams. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel right here, and if you want to learn more from me, check out these videos over here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you later.